It's always good practice to simplify the slope geometry after importing it. And this is because simplifying the geometry will help to expedite any subsequent process. So there are two ways to simplify. The first is by reducing the number of surface triangles that make up the slope. The second way is to reduce the number of vertices or points that make up the triangles. So there is no right or wrong as to which method to use, as long as the features important to the analysis are preserved during the simplification process. So if you wanted to, you can use one or the other, or a combination can also be used. So first, let me show you how to simplify the number of triangles. Make sure the surface is selected. Go to Geometry, Surface Triangulation Tools, then Simplify Triangulation. In this dialog, you can see the current number of triangles. You can reduce the resolution to a predefined level, or you can customize the resolution. So let's reduce by triangle count to about 23500. So this is about 50% of the existing number of triangles. And in fact, it's recommended that you reduce by a maximum of 50% per iteration. So let's just click OK. And we're done simplifying by triangles. Let me undo to show you the other method. OK, so the second method for simplification is by points. We do this by selecting the slope, Geometry, Surface Triangulation Tools, then Add Surface from Existing Points, which takes you to a dialog that allows you to modify points. Okay, so here you can see the list of vertices. You can also see the current number of points is about 24,000. To simplify, make sure the simplification box is checked. The method by which points are eliminated from the slope is random sampling, and you can specify the number of points to keep. And 50% is a good rule of thumb. And let's click OK. And this concludes the simplification video.